our honorable and most beloved, most revered President of India, Honorable Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harshvardhan, Secretary to the President of India, Srimati Omita Paul, Mr. Francis Gray, Director General of World Intellectual Property Organizations, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Professor Anil Gupta, Srimati Ilaben Bed, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. May I extend a very warm welcome to you all to this 9th National Grassroots Innovations and Outstanding Traditional Knowledge Awards function. I want to begin by thanking our Honorable President for fueling a national innovation movement which will reinvent India as an innovation nation. Festival of Innovation is just a part of this great national movement that has been inspired by our Honorable President. Our Honorable President has been an extraordinary advocate of grassroots innovation, inclusive innovation. At all levels in our society, with the aim of making it compassionate, creative, a collaborative, innovative society. And one has witnessed this fueling over the last few years in terms of the way the status of grassroots innovation has increased. Began with Honorable President giving the awards to these barefoot innovators, then holding this biennial exhibition. But we know that the grassroots innovation has a permanent place in the heart of our Honorable President. And just a couple of months ago, we have had the inauguration of the permanent exhibition in Rashtrapati Bhavan. It will stay permanently in Rashtrapati Bhavan. That is the status. And he's such a strong believer in the fact that everyone is someone, the fact that India does not have just 1.3 billion mouths, but 1.3 billion minds, that for the first time in our history this year, grassroots innovators have been honored with the highest civilian award, the Padma Awards. This has never happened before. And we are particularly proud that these were awardees of our National Innovation Foundation and Srishti. In moving this innovation movement forward, we require speed, we require scale, we require sustainability. And thanks to the inspiration of our Honorable President, the entire nation is galvanizing together. After all, NIF's agenda is not that of NIF, it's a national agenda. And there has to be a national ownership. So I'm very proud to see how CSIR, how DBT, how ICMR, how ICAR, and several other national institutions now are coming together to support and partner in this grassroots innovation movement. We talked about scale with Department of Science and Technology. They have a wonderful program, Inspire, for young school children. And then this program, which is on million minds, augmenting national inspiration through knowledge, Manak as it is called, and NIF is a partner. And can you believe it? A million ideas at the rate of 2 ideas per school from 4.5 lakh schools is what we are aiming at. So we are talking about such big scales. This entire inspiration has come from our Honorable President. We want to, sir, thank you again. And we have no doubt that the extraordinary energy, extraordinary inspiration, extraordinary aspiration that you have created will actually make sure that our dream of reinventing India as an inclusive innovation nation will come true, and sooner rather than later. Thank you very much.
Many thanks, Dr. Ari Mashelkar. And now I'll request Professor Anil Gupta, Executive Vice Chairperson, National Innovation Foundation, for his speech.
Honorable President, Honorable Minister of Science and Technology, Dr. Harshvardhan, my old friend, a very eminent innovation champion of the world, Dr. Francis Gary, who, as you all know, is also instrumental behind the Global Innovation Index, Dr. Ari Mashelkar, Ila Bhan, Mrs. Amita Paul is one person who has steered from the Office of the President the entire festival of the innovation that we are witnessing today. I want to particularly mention the energy that we draw from her inspiring steering of all the activities that we have taken up in the last many years. The legacy of the President 2012-2017 will be remembered in the history of our country for having given a new stature to the grassroots voices, which are getting not only voice, but velocity and visibility of an unprecedented nature. We are very proud from the National Innovation Foundation and the Honeybee Network that we have been able to get innovators from 22 states. This time, the entries of 33,000 entries came from all the states and union territories of the country. We have reached almost 560 districts. We aim to reach all the 700 and odd districts of the country so that no region will remain untapped for the creativity of at the grassroots level. We're very proud that this festival is also accompanied with one of the most unique initiatives in the world. India is probably the only country where head of the state hosts 10 scholars in innovation, scholar in residence for innovation at the President of India's house, along with the writer and the artist. Now, this has never happened before. For 2 weeks, these innovation scholars will stay at the Rashtrapati Bhavan, will attend all the activities, will be meeting cabinet ministers, will be meeting secretaries, and various mentors. They will be mentored under the leadership of Mrs. Amita Paul for taking their ideas forward. This is a message that Office of the President has given to every one of us that India cares about inclusive innovation, about creativity at grassroots. Thank you so much.
Respected Honorable President Shri Pranab Mukherjee ji, Director General, World Intellectual Property Organization, Dr. Francis Gurry, Dr. Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary DST, Dr. R. A. Mashelkar, Shrimati Alaben Bhatt, Mrs. Amita Paul, Professor Anil Gupta, my dear innovators, students, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, friends from the media. Let me begin by congratulating all the grassroots innovators and students who would be receiving awards at the hands of our Honorable Rashtrapati ji. All of you are indeed very lucky to have the blessings of our President, who has always been quite generous in his appreciation for the right causes and far-sighted in his approach towards innovation. I would like to express my sincere, heartfelt gratitude to him for the many initiatives on innovation he and his office have taken up in the last few years. Friends, our country faces a lot of technological challenges on which the scientific community has been working on. I have observed that many grassroots innovators, like the ones sitting in this audience, who are outside the formal systems of science and technology, have also been noticing such problems and trying to develop effective solutions for the same. National Innovation Foundation, India, an institution under my ministry, has documented and recognized hundreds of such attempts by individuals and communities, many of which may be world-class, as evident by the grant of the 5 US patents to grassroots innovators and a traditional knowledge holder. There are hundreds and thousands of such innovators all across the country who are similarly wanting and waiting to be identified and requiring a chance. The aspirations of such innovators can only be fulfilled if there are enabling policies and institutions put in place. The central government, under the various activities of Atal Innovation Mission, Startup India, and Skill Development Program, is widely promoting innovation, skill building, and entrepreneurship amongst the people. The Ministry of Science and Technology, through its Department of Science and Technology, Biotechnology, and Scientific and Industrial Research, has a number of initiatives for innovation promotion, technology development, IPR protection, and entrepreneurship development, etc. Starting from an idea of a school student, an innovation by a farmer, or a mechanic to a technology of a professional in a formal research and development laboratory, the various schemes of the ministry provide support to people of all ages, all educational, and all occupational backgrounds. Through its various initiatives, the government has been trying to put in place all the missing linkages and retune and recalibrate the existing ones. Now there has been so much attention, thrust and emphasis on innovation and entrepreneurship, establishing viable functional linkages between various schemes and institutions. Therefore, becomes very important to nurture an enabling ecosystem for the growth of an innovation. Friends, I am very happy that under the guidance of the Honorable President, the Rashtrapati Bhavan, through this festival of innovation, has been providing such a platform where different stakeholders of an innovation incubation chain can come, interact, and forge partnerships. This is another unique initiative at the highest level, which does not find a parallel anywhere in the world. When the first citizen of the country emphasizes a cause, everyone in the country stands up and takes notice. The various initiatives of the Rashtrapati Bhavan have underlined the importance of understanding innovation in the first place, putting it in use in the right perspective, and establishing networks that could leverage the utility of these innovations in the best possible way. Friends, in my address at the Indian Science Congress inaugural event this year, I had exhorted the scientific fraternity to pick up and start working on fundamental issues and problems of the people. I reiterate that we need to evaluate ourselves in terms of the delivery we have been able to make to the people of India, and not solely in terms of the number of patents filed or the papers published. To what extent we have been able to provide technological solutions to the society addressing their needs, we need to introspect and evaluate. In my view, the science and technology system has to be more responsive and responsible towards societal needs. India has a well-established science and technology system in place, both at the central as well as the state level. I suggest the respective state councils of science and technology to work in close cooperation with various science and technology institutions and bodies, and especially with the National Innovation Foundation, which can be a source of useful innovations, oblique technologies addressing problems in the respective states. Similarly, NIF can leverage upon the network of the councils to further its activities in the state and take the identified innovations from the state to the national level. Similar synergy can be explored and developed at the center with the central schemes, as well as like the case of Inspire Manak scheme of DST, where DST and National Innovation Foundation are now working together to promote innovation among school students. Under the scheme, in addition to monetary support to students for their ideas and recognition at the district, state, and the national level, NIF will also incubate the top 60 innovations of the students. This takes us a step forward from only awarding projects like in the earlier Inspire scheme to incubating innovations in the revised Inspire Manak scheme. We need to think on similar lines in all other applicable cases as well. How do the people of our country reap the benefits of the technological developments our public science and technology institutions are making? Science in service of society is the new mantra. I wish to propose and through it communicate the government's expectations from our highly qualified, hard-working and devoted scientific community. I am sure that our scientists will rise to the occasion and help the government to make our country self-reliant in sustainable technologies that not only can serve the needs of our people, but also of others in Africa, Latin America, Southeast Asia, and elsewhere. Friends, I have observed the working of the National Innovation Foundation closely in the last 3 years. I am happy to state that I find them taking the resolve and commitment of this government forward by ensuring that no worthy innovative idea remains unsupported in this country. For this, I compliment the team of National Innovation Foundation. I am told that last year the DST had supported NIF for the establishment of a technology business incubator. This is a very good initiative which will not only help grassroots innovators establish companies and scale up their work, but also others who may be interested in establishing enterprises based on grassroots innovations. I hope in the coming years, in line with the Startup India program of the government, there will be exciting success stories of grassroots innovations-based enterprises set up under the incubator. Friends, with this, I come to the end of my address. I once again congratulate all the award winners hailing from different parts of the country and greet the distinguished guests who are here to witness this event. I hope that you will all get inspired by the work of the grassroots innovators and they will feel motivated by your generous appreciation. Once again, we thank our Honorable Rashtrapati Ji for his gracious present and blessings to all of us. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Your Excellency Shri Pranab Mukherjee, President of India, Honourable Ministers, distinguished members of the podium, distinguished guests, it's really a privilege, a great privilege and an honour for the World Intellectual Property Organization as the United Nations lead agency in the field of innovation to be able to participate in this ceremony this morning, which, if I may say, has all the vibrancy of innovation in India and the innovation scene in India. I should like to thank His Excellency the President, the National Innovation Foundation and the other organization, other organizers for this opportunity to be present this morning. Innovation has long been recognized, of course, as offering the possibility of enhanced economic development, of raising living standards and of improving the quality of material life. The third festival of innovation, of course, recognizes this potential, but it does so, if I may say, in a way which pays attention not only to the production of innovation, but also to the means of the social implementation and realization of innovation. It pays attention not only to the question of the quantitative production of innovation, but also to the extremely important, equally important questions of the social means of the production of innovation and the distribution of its benefits. It thus recognizes that for innovation to be truly successful, it must be inclusive. In order for innovation to be inclusive, the policies and the institutions of innovation also have to be inclusive. Intellectual property is one such policy and institution. Indeed, the whole reason for which we have intellectual property is innovation, to encourage the promotion of innovation. So as we recognize that innovation itself must be responsive to social needs, So we must recognize that intellectual property as an institution of innovation must be inclusive and responsive to social needs. Over recent years, I believe that intellectual property has emerged from a position of isolationism to one of engagement with the society and the economy that it serves. One example of this in new engagement is the exercise that is currently underway at the World Intellectual Property Organization to establish an international protection for traditional knowledge and traditional cultural expressions. This is an exercise in which India has been not only a political leader, but also very much a thought leader. And many of the early movers, such as Professor Anil Gupta and the Honeybee Network, are present this morning. Many of the early movers of this international movement for the recognition of traditional knowledge. So WIPO is thus especially delighted to be able to participate in this ceremony of awards for grassroots innovations and outstanding traditional knowledge. And we congratulate both those who have organized this ceremony and those who will be awarded their just rewards during the ceremony today. Thank you very much.
May I now request the Honorable President of India to please present the 9th National Biennial Award for Grassroots Innovations and Outstanding Traditional Knowledge. And we'll start with awards. First, we'll call Bhanjibhai Mathukia from the state of Gujarat. He's been conferred with Lifetime Achievement Award. Bhanjibhai Mathukia. Second award is being given to late Shri Purushottam Bhai Patel posthumously, and on his behalf, his wife Srimati Surekha Ben. Third, for Khasi and Jaintia community from Meghali, this is for the category National One Community Award, the Living Root Bridges of Meghalaya, a community developed, community nurtured grassroots innovation. Surinder Prasad from Uttar Pradesh in the category of National One Agriculture Machinery for Modified Combined Harvester. Moa Subong from Nagaland in the category of National One General Utility for Bamhum, a bamboo vine musical instrument. We'll call T. Vengadapati Rediar from Puducherry in the category of National One for Plant Variety, Improved Crossandra and Casuarina Varieties. Next we have Laduben Somabhai Bhambi for the Community Award from Gujarat, category National One, Herbal Medication for Treating Anistress in Bovines. Nabujit Bharali from Assam in the category of National 2 under General Utility, Improved Wheelchair for Physically Challenged and Silk Reeling Cum Spinning Machine. Shravan Kumar Bajia from Rajasthan in the category of National 2, Agriculture Machinery, Onion Harvester and Motorcycle Operated Salt Turning Device. Diptanshu Malviya and Mukul Malviya from Rajasthan in the category of National 2 for Mechanical Wrapper Picker. Next we have Hariman Sharma from Himachal Pradesh in the category of National 2 for Plant Variety, for Approved Variety for Low Altitude. Next we have Sheikh Hibazat Hussain from Bihar, for the category of National 2, Veterinary, for Herbal Medication for Curing Ephemeral Fever. We now have Madan Lal Kumawat from Rajasthan From Telangana, we have K. Panduranga Rao in the category of National Tree, that is for transport, innovative air sealant to stop puncture. Next, from Gujarat, we have Vallabhai Vasrambhai Marvania in the category of National Third Plant Variety, Madhavan Gajar Improved Carrot Variety. Next is Madan Lal Devada from Rajasthan in the category of National Third Plant Variety, Durga 4 Improved Carrot Variety. From Gujarat, we have Shravak Karshan Bhai Govind Bhai for the Community Award, and that is for veterinary herbal medication for retention of placenta in animals. And after national awards, we'll move on to the state awards, and we'll call Mansa Ram Suthar and Mala Ram Suthar from Rajasthan for groundnut digger and disc harrow seed drill. Next, we have from Karnataka, Ganesh Shetty for robotic sprayer. Next award has been given jointly. It's for Mohammad Shafi Iyengar from Jammu and Kashmir for PCB repairing device for mobile phones. Next award is also joint. Again from Jammu and Kashmir, Mohammad Rafiq Ahangar from Multipurpose Tool for Carpentry. Next we have Maibam Deben Singh from Manipur for Cooking Cum Drying Stove. We'll call J. Rajasekhar, A. Nivashini and K. Ratna simultaneously for the state of Tamil Nadu, step lock system in bus. This is innovation. From Uttar Pradesh and Chandigarh, we have Kulsum Rizvi, Tarun Anand, and Sanvi Agarwal for posture correcting chair. Next, we have Sapam Lukhoi Singh from Manipur for Chingdin Thabi Improved Cucumber Variety. From Madhya Pradesh, we have Kashinath N. Lukhante for Improved Soyabean Variety. And for the next state award from Chhattisgarh, we'll call Leela Ram Sahu for improved brinjal variety. Next we have from Kerala, D. Vasinibai for improved anthurium varieties and their planting method. And in the state award category, we have from Jharkhand, Sitanath Munda for herbal medication for treating bloat in animals.
Dr. Harshvardhan, Minister of Science and Technology, Government of India. Srimati Amita Paul, Secretary to the President. Dr. Francis Gadi, DG, WIPO. Dr. Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology. Dr. R. A. Masalkar, Chairperson, National Innovation Foundation, Professor Anil Gupta, Executive Vice Chairperson, National Innovation Foundation, Srimati Ilaben Patel, Ilaben Bhatt, founder, Self-Employment Women Association, recipients of the 9th Biennial Awards for Grassroots Innovation and Outstanding Traditional Knowledge, distinguished delegates, innovators attending the Festival of Innovation, ladies and gentlemen. At the very outset, I would like to welcome all the distinguished guests coming from different parts of the country and abroad to participate in the 9th National Biennial Award for Grassroots Innovations and Outstanding Traditional Knowledge. At the outset, let me congratulate the award winners for the contribution in the sphere of innovation. Behind their beaming faces, which I can see, lie their hard work and perseverance. I am told that more than 33,000 entries were received, out of which only 32 innovators have been chosen and bestowed with the national and state awards today. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen. Innovation has reached center stage of policy making in the science and technology domain. This has strengthened the resolve of the government to encourage innovation and innovation-based enterprises. At the same time, it has helped in unlocking the latent creative energy of our billion-plus people. I take this opportunity to applaud the efforts of the National Innovation Foundation. It has been working diligently in stimulating the creativity and innovativeness at the grassroots levels all over the country. As we recognize the unsung heroes of our society today, we also ought to take a pledge to further enrich the ecosystem around inclusive innovations. We need all public and private systems around the grassroots innovations to become empathetic and enablers. And we need to do it, not just for India, but for the whole world. I am happy that Director General of World Intellectual Property Organizations, Dr. Francis Gary, is here with us today. I am sure he will also see how important it is to give due weightage to the source of creativity and innovations emanating at the grassroots. It can generate jobs and livelihood for masses all around the world. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, the global economy continues to remain weak. The industrial growth is becoming more jobless in nature, even in emerging economy. In such a scenario, the Gandhian model of decentralized, distributed and diversified innovation-based enterprises is perhaps the way forward and to solve the problems. Gandhiji had always wanted to blend modern science and technology with community knowledge and institutions. His message has become extremely relevant in today's context. National Innovation Foundation has created, within the last decade and a half, several important conceptual and policy milestones. I have witnessed the creativity of children, school and college students, and grassroots innovators. However, the emergence of an adequate, of an inclusive innovation ecosystem uniquely suited in India requires several more steps than what has already been taken by the government and the civil society. Dear friends, let me share some of the initiatives we have taken at Rashtrapati Bhavan, mainly at the initiatives of my secretary, which are aimed at promoting and augmenting the ecosystem by grassroots innovators. To create a feeling of celebration of grassroots and inclusive innovations in the country, the earlier exhibition of innovation has become a week-long festival of innovation. The roundtables on inclusive innovations, public service delivery, and financing of innovations have been enthusiastic participants of distinguished experts with many concrete deliverables having emerged from these sessions. The Visitors Award for Best University Researcher and Innovator from Central Universities was initiated in 2014. These awards provide a link between the innovation movement at grassroots level with the institutions of higher education. Excellence is indivisible. A healthy combination of excellence and relevance at all levels of society, particularly among academic institutions, is called for. The Visitors Awards are a testimony to that. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, the institutions of higher learning need to have an interface with the grassroots innovators. The academia has to closely study and understand how creative minds among the common people can solve local problems without much help from outside. If they can get support from formal institutions, they can do much more. I called upon the higher educational institutions to organize exhibition of grassroots innovators, invite innovators to the classroom, and set up innovation clubs. I am told that 90 representatives from such clubs in different institutions will be meeting on 8th March. The innovation clubs encourage students to search, spread, and celebrate innovations and sense the unmet social needs. If the inventory of unmet social and technological needs of 6.6 lakh villages and small towns of India can act as a stimulus for research and project work, nothing can stop India from becoming a world leader in inclusive innovations. Efforts of this direction will have to be complemented by deeper process which change the key stakeholders with missionary zeal and make effect a difference. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, to speak of myself, I began my career as a teacher first. Hence, I fully understand the role of a teacher plays in the life of students. Teachers, by their own conduct and example, can mould the students into responsible human beings, sensible to the problems of society and caring enough to contribute towards their elevations. Such inspired teachers who can share students, who can shape students with creative and innovative individuals should be encouraged. I have had the privilege to host inspired teachers from central universities and other institutions at Rashtrapati Bhavan under a special initiative called the In-Residence Program. Such teachers feel motivated to rededicate themselves to the cause of inclusion, excellence, and social relevance. Creative persons like artists, writers, and innovation scholars, too, have stayed as in the program of In-Residence at Rashtrapati Bhavan. They have been mentored by the scientists, technical experts, and policy makers to make the full depth of their innovations. It will be meeting the fourth batch. I will be meeting the fourth batch of these scholars as they start their 2-week in-residence programs starting from today. A message that this country cares about grassroots innovators and other creative pursuits should reach everywhere. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, it is important to imbibe in children a spirit of scientific inquiry. We must encourage them to pursue their curiosity and creativity. We must help them discover the fascination of creating something new. Thousands of visitors, including children, come to Shri Rashtrapati Bhavan regularly. A permanent exhibition of inclusive innovations has been installed to highlight the cultural creativity and educational, institutional, and technological innovations scouted from all over the country. I'm sure that this exhibition will inspire every visitor to experiment and innovate. India is poised to take the fruits of development through initiatives like Startups India, Digital India, Clean India, to all corners of the country. Ideas of innovation will make a true difference only if all of us, in different roles and institutions, join hands in creating Shambedanshilata and Srijanshilata, compassion and creativity in the country. With these few words, I conclude. Let me once again congratulate all the award winners. Let the forces of creativity and ingenuity be with you always. Wish you all success in your future endeavors. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.